just checked out all the engagement rings.
Yeah.
They've only been going together for a year, now all of a sudden, makes them act really weird. That boy acts really weird.
Yeah.
Something about love makes guys act crazy. And why don't we do that when we love Jesus?
Yeah.
Amen.
How can we say we love Jesus that doesn't do anything to us? Yeah. How can you not love the things that he loves? And when you love the things he loves, then you just fall in love with him, and you love him more and more and more. And you know, one of the things that I can tell you beyond a shadow of a doubt, I didn't love my wife at all when we first got married in comparison to how much I love her now.
Amen.
Our love has grown.
Yeah.
I even like hanging out with her.
Amen.
And I'm telling you, I tell men this all the time. You want your wife to do what you tell her? Hire her. Pay her, and she'll do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not kidding. I hired her about 5 years ago, and she just does everything I tell her. Come on.
Yeah.
We spend 24/7 together, and I love it. Because I love her. I have people say, well, I don't have time to pray. Really? Have you ever had something really exciting happen to you in your life that you couldn't wait to get home and tell your wife?
Yeah.
I'm that way about just about everything. We had one of the dear friends of ours recently passed away, named Raymond Smith. And he was a dear friend of ours. We went on vacation together, we traveled together, we had a great time. So my wife invited his wife to come and spend a week with us at our house. And my wife just ministered to her and ministered to her. So I basically lost my wife for about a week. But she didn't have time to mess with me and mess with her, so she took care of her. I couldn't wait to get back and say, honey, guess what's happened this week?
Yeah.
How come we don't love the Lord that much?
Yeah.
I can't wait to tell Jesus stuff. You say, well, he already knows. I know, but I want to make sure he knows. I love it. Now, folks, if Jesus really is coming, it ought to have an effect on your life.
Amen.
He said, what manner of person ought you to be? Well, I'm just giving you two things today. I could go on and say a giver. I could go on and say a prayer warrior. I could go on and say a Bible scholar. On and on we can go.
Yeah, yeah.
But I feel like this. If a person is saved and he really loves the Lord, the rest of that stuff will take care of itself.
Amen.
Amen. So let me ask you this. Jesus really is coming.
Yep.
Now, I know he hasn't come yet, but he will.
Yeah. Yep.
What manner of person ought you to be if you believe that? I want you to bow your heads with me. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Folks, wouldn't it be a good thing to quit acting like you have something you don't have? Only person in this room knows whether you're saved or not is you. Now the Lord knows, and the Lord tells you, so you know, but nobody else does. Are you really saved this morning? How about let's lay aside all the nonsense that we have and how we hide stuff and cover up stuff. Are you really saved? Do you really want the rapture to come? If the rapture was to come right this minute, would you be sitting in this room all by yourself? Say, well, the Lord wouldn't do that to me. Yes, he would, and he will, because he said so. Heavenly Father, sure do love you today. Thank you so much for Jesus Christ. Thank you that we can love our Lord, and we can honestly have an emotional attachment to our Savior. Pray you bless in this service today. Lord, there could be some folks in this room that's not saved, and all this time, they know they're not saved. The Holy Spirit revealed to them they're not saved. And they keep acting like they have something they don't. God, would you help them lay all that aside today? Just come take the preacher by the hand and say, I want to get saved. I'm tired of playing this game. Lord, there may be some folks in this room that's allowed their love for Jesus Christ to become cold. Circumstances has got them off track. And they don't really love him with all their heart, their mind, and their soul, and their will this morning. So they need to come and just simply say, Lord, I want to love you again like I'm supposed to. God, would you speak to us today? What would you make a difference in our life? We pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Would you stand with us?